So hearing Shravana, according to Bhagavat Mahatma, you can hear like a parrot. There are many parrots in India. The parrot has the ability to hear and repeat to others. They call prachara, achara, prachara. Achara means, prachara means to speak. Achara means to follow what you are speaking. So he hears and then he repeats. Another good way of shravana is to hear like a fish. The fish, he lives in the ocean of milk, according to the Bhagavat Mahatma. Not the fish that lives in an Indian ocean, but those who live in the ocean of milk, they keep on drinking nectar, unblinkingly, paying undivided attention. So that is shravana, where you hear like a fish. And then another way of hearing, you can hear, there is a fish, chatak, and you can hear like a Burunda bird which lives in the Himalaya. So all these animals are given there as examples, as gurus for shravana. So here, I think.
So this island is for shravana. Like Parabhatam says, Yasyam Vaishvyamanaya Krishna Paramapurusha Bhaktir Utpadyati Pumsaha Sohamoha Bhayapaha. That simply by giving oral reception to the Bhagavatam, the loving devotional service to Krishna will sprout up from our hearts. And what happens after that? Soha moha bhayapaha. It will extinguish the fire of lamentation, the fire of illusion, and the fire of fear. We are experiencing these three fires in the material world. Fear, lamentation, and illusion. So it says that our shravana will extinguish these three kinds of fires. You may say, no, I don't have any problem. Maybe it's still coming. So here in Samanta Deep, we can increase our hearing by hearing all the great souls that have come here to feed our ears so that our devotion service can sprout up from our hearts. Krishna Bhakti is there in the heart. It needs to be watered by Shravana. So please take the opportunity to drink the nectar of Gaura Lila in this holy dam from these great souls that have come to feed you. Thank you, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna! Hare Krishna! Krishna Krishna! Hare Hare! Hare Rama! Hare Rama! Rama Rama! Hare Hare! Thank you, very good. You are better than before now.
Pancharatna is still rehearsing. Okay. So Lord Shiva, Panchavakra Shiva, five-headed Lord Shiva. We see Chaturmukha Brahma and Panchamukha Shiva. So the five mouths of Lord Shiva are all chanting. What are they chanting? Right? Brahma Boli. Mahadevo Panchamukhi. So Lord Shiva is always chanting the name of Lord Ram. But we know also when Lord Rama went to cross over to Lanka, who did he worship? Yeah, he worshiped Shiva, right? Why? Some people ask Prabhupada, why like that? If Lord Rama is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, why he worshiped Lord Shiva? Prabhupada said, he was telling Lord Shiva, I'm going there to kill your devotee. Ravan is also the devotee of Shiva, right? He got the benediction he wanted from Lord Shiva. He wanted opulence, he wanted power, he wanted so many material things. So Shiva fulfilled his desires, he got them, but he did not get the real mercy of Lord Shiva. The real mercy of Lord Shiva is to get Krishna Bhakti. We're going to see in this drama how the Brahmanas who were living here in this place, Belpukur, this name Belpukur, this is the new name. Originally it was called Bilvavan. None different from Bilvavan in Vrindavan. There's a place in Vrindavan, Bilvavan. So Bilvapaksha, this place. Now it's called Belpukur. So the Bilva leaf, it's a special leaf which is used to worship Lord Shiva. Just like we worship Lord Vishnu with Tulasi leaves. So the devotees of Lord Shiva, they worship him with this Bilva leaf. Udampan. Bil. Yeah. Did you have some Bil juice? You drinking it every morning? This is Belpukur. You see, they're selling, every year we come here, they're always selling Bel fruits here. Right? People with a bald head shouldn't walk under a Bel tree. Because if the Bel fruit falls on your head, very painful, right? So you don't walk under the Bel tree. So we came to this place to hear the glories of Lord Shiva, how he helped the devotees, these brahmanas who came into the forest, they were worshipping him, and Lord Shiva became kind to them. And he asked the brahmanas, what do you want? What's your desire? And the brahmanas told Lord Shiva, we want the greatest thing. We want the best thing we can, what's the greatest thing you can give us? Just like Sanatana Goswami, the same kind of Leela there with Sanatana Goswami. The man came to Sanatana and he heard he's got some Chintamani that he can transform something into anything he could touch. This stone, Chintamani stone, it can make gold. So the man thought, this is wonderful, I've got to get a stone like that. But when he came to Sanatana Goswami, Sanatana Goswami said, oh, that stone, it's over there in the garbage. You know, just like they were telling us at Madan Mohan, throw your garbage in the pit. So Sanatana Goswami had one pit there, and he said, Chintamani stone's in there. And the man went in there and came out with a stone. He was so happy, so joyful. And he thought, this is wonderful. He could make so much gold. But then he began to consider, why he threw it away? He must have something more valuable than that. So he begged Sanatana Goswami, please give me the most valuable thing you've got. So Sanatana said, then you have to throw away that Chintamani stone. Throw it in the Yamuna. And so the man was very reluctant, very hesitant. But Sanatana said, you want the most valuable thing? You have to get rid of that stone. Right? Sometimes we want Krishna consciousness, but we want to hold on to all of our material attachments as well. We have to let go. You can't hold on to both. You know, you're going on the boat, you can't have one foot in one boat and another foot in a different boat. So the same way we want Krishna consciousness, we have to let go of all the material attachments, all the maya. then we can fully take shelter of Krishna. So when the man threw away the stone, then Sanatana Goswami gave him some japa beads and said, now you sit here and chant Hare Krishna. So similarly, Lord Shiva tested these brahmanas, and we're going to see in Pancharatna's drama now how the brahmanas were rewarded by Lord Shiva, right?
Do you like our ad-free videos? Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.